work with the Indian handicrafts or the, going to the villages, finding those colors. You know, Reshma Shira was such a revolution for me because it was so authentic. Vaidaji wearing all that jewelry, that kind of costume. People never dressed you like that because there was, it was still the period of the 70s where you had... At the same time, she did Buddha Mil Gaya with Vijayanti Bala, which I was shocked to see Vijayanti Bala in that costume. I couldn't believe that she would be wearing that. How do you look at that aspect of it?
I think it's mind-blowing. Mind-blowing because the amount of research that she did when it comes to embroidery, jewelry, everything is spectacular. It is amazing. And of course, Buddha Mil Gaya, she does say that, you know, back then women were not quite that daring to wear those kind of clothes. But, you know, she pushed that barrier. Hence, great, great job.
So, if you have to now look at her work, we're talking about that she's pushed the barriers, she's moved. But what is that one quality? It's not just about, is it the sense of, not just the dressing of tight fitting is the sense, but also the sense of colors, which I think is so important because I read that in the book itself that she was matching it to the roses, you know. How do you look at that?
I think we can speak about Sir's film. Yeah. There is, if you see the film and the way it's been shot, nobody ever seems, whether it's the background, whether it's the cinematography, whether it's the costume, it's almost, sir, I shouldn't be talking about your film like that, but it was just what I remember from the film is everything stood out, but nothing ever stood out.
Yeah.
And I think that is just brilliant. That means everybody was in synergy, including the costume designer, including the actors who were willing to wear what the costume designer gave, including the DOP, including the art director, including the director. I think that is a testament to every person on that set.
Yeah.
So just looking at Sir's film, you know, whether it was... Because there were two distinct styles. You know, there was Western clothing, yeah, and then there was Eastern clothing. And they all kind of came together. It never looked like they were in two different worlds. And that I thought was brilliant.
Yeah, I think it's tremendous because to do both ranges,
yes,
which is very rare for costume designers,
exactly,
because you normally pick what is good in Western or what
yes,
is good in thing. Ashu, that also brings the point of the fact that keeping the director's vision, you know, while Sonam is saying that she kept the colors and thing, but was it the vision of yours? Because finally, you're the filmmaker, you have a vision which you want. How close was she to your vision?
You know, if I may say that she was absolutely, after hearing the narration and after doing the sessions where she's, you know, trying to, you know, absorb what the vision of the script is and what you're trying to say as a story, when she came up with the design, she was always bang on the first one. There was never any back and forth in which, you know, I'm saying to her that ye thoda sa change kar dijiye, ye aisa nahi hoga, waisa nahi hoga. She was always bang on. And apart from the silhouette and all of that, she had a great sense of drama. She knew how to take a character and give it that one little thrust which makes that entire outfit look stand out for the character, make a mark. Is, for example, a Swadesh. When we moved on to Swadesh from Lagan, here is a costume designer who's done Reshma or Shera, and she's done Lakin, and she's done the village life.
Yeah, yeah.
But still, she wants to, once again, when we went to Bhuj, she wanted to go to all the neighboring villages of Bhuj, look at how the people are dressing, you know, try and take from them, absorb from that, create the silhouette for Swadesh, for Lagan. And for Swadesh, it was a village again, it was contemporary. And we had to first create a silhouette for Mohan Bhargav. Not once did we think about, you know, here we have a star who's going to play this character and we should do something to cater to him. No, our approach was that, what is Mohan Bhargav? What does he require? And then how Shah Rukh seamlessly fits into that and comes in. So her sense of, you know, if I may just add a little bit over here, if you look at the 60s and the 70s, she was popular with not only the actors and the actresses, but she was also popular with the producers and the directors, which means a very big thing because those are all huge filmmakers. So there was a certain process, a method of functioning absolutely gentle soul. If you interact with her,
yeah.
She was a woman of very few words, but they were very measured, very firm, and very definite. So I think that was something which was really a part of her persona, which came into her movies. And if I may, on a closing note of mine, if I may add, here is a person who's done Ali Baba aur 40 Chor,
yeah.
Fantasy, Soni Mahiwal, which is Eternal Love Story. And from here, she goes to the West and does a very subtle version of Gandhi.
Yeah.
How does that happen? A person who is all the time creating these larger than life looks for so many heroines and song and dance, now is doing Gandhi. I think that's an outstanding transition which
absolutely.
She did then.
No, thanks, yeah. Shruti, you had one costume designer, and I'm going to come back to you, Solam, on that. One costume designer designing the whole film. Now in films, you see everyone has a costume designer. My question is that Banuji could do that because there was a vision of the director and she followed that and she... So how difficult it is now when you're trying to match the vision, or there are 10 costume designers trying to match the vision of the director in one film?
I think one costume designer doing the work is only so tough. 10 together, putting all their minds and brains together is extremely tough. But I feel if you find that mid-ground and that similar note, once you have got the note, everything is easy. But getting 10 of them together, or when there are too many designers doing a film, it's not an easy job.
Yeah. How do you look at that, Sonam? Because as an actor...
I don't agree with having several costume designers on a film. Whichever film I've been a part of, I've tried to convince the other... I mean, fortunately for me, I've worked in films besides like bigger actors, you know, when my co-stars, when they have their own costume designer, whether it was an Aisha, whether it was a Neerja, whether it was, a Delhi Six or a Ranjana. I work with the costume designer who is working on the whole film. And, we kind of do it together. For example, in a Delhi Six, Bharti was doing the clothes of the film. She wanted certain silhouettes. So I introduced her to Anamika, who's not a fashion designer. She's a fashion designer. She's not a costume designer. But she designed the clothes with the costume designer's vision. In Ranjana, I worked with the costume designer. So for me, I'm not very comfortable working with my own costume designer. I'm a director's actor and I'm a producer's actor. You know, I'm a producer with my sister, absolutely. Myself, and I don't agree with that. Now there's a new trend where one costume designer will only do the leads and there'll be another costume designer who will do the background artists and stuff like that. There's never a synergy between the two.
Agree.
And in my last two films, we had that problem. And I do not agree with it. It's like having three DOPs on a film.
Yeah, absolutely.
Or having two directors. I feel the lead, these are HODs of a film.
Yeah.
And an HOD should be an HOD. There shouldn't be five HODs. I mean, that's might be a little controversial, as usual, statement. So for me, I haven't, maybe in like a Prem Ratan Dhan Payo or maybe a big film where I'm a part of a big film, then I will have to have my own designer, because everybody has multiple designers. But in the films that I've done, which are my smaller films that I do, we've not had that.
Okay, yeah.
Sorry.
I agree. We that's the way it should be. Sorry.
Sorry.
Yeah. Ashu, Akbar and Jodha Akbar, I mean, how did you decide to, with Banuji, to set the period? Because I know it's 16th century, it's the time of Akbar. But still, I mean, to get the costumes and to get... What was the... You know, it's very fascinating for me to understand the research on that aspect. And how did you work about the colors?
Yeah. No, let me correct you a little bit on that.
Yeah.
So, I wanted Bhanutai for Jodha Akbar.
Yeah.
But by that time, she wanted to reduce all her work.
Yeah. It.
So she had to, despite my persistence and trying to request her, she had to pass on it.
Yeah.
So Jodha Akbar was done by Neeta Lulla.
Okay. Yeah.
But if I may add to that,
yeah,
just to give you a sense of the grace of an HOD, the grace of Bhanu Athaiya.
Yeah.
This very book that you're holding just now,
yeah,
has got a chapter on jewelry. And though she was not connected with the film at all, she has praised Jodha Akbar in the book.
Yeah, I know.
Where she talks about the design, she says about how accurate the all the designs were, how the jewelry was, how yeah. the whole wardrobe of the film was, which I thought was a very, very graceful thing to do. Yeah. But for her to say it in her own book,
right?
Appreciation, I think that was amazing.
You know, yeah. So I think Avi had shot the posters with just the, I think they were mid shots, I remember so clearly. And I remember going to the cinema and, you know, they were backlit. Those, and I just thought they were such striking images, and they felt new, and at the same time they felt like they were from a long time ago. At yeah. the same time, yeah,
setting that period. Yeah, Shruti, you've seen Banuji's work over the years. Tell me about one aspect of Banuji which still, I mean, does any, I mean, what inspires you?
Just one?
Maybe two, maybe three, yeah.
So I think after reading her book, one thing that really inspires me about her is at for no other, every film that she's done,